Straight off the bat, while the Insta360 GO 3 might not boast cinema quality footage, what it lacks in quality, it makes up in versatility. You can get shots with this little camera that other cameras can't even dream of, and trust me, in some of those shots, no one's gonna be squinting at pixels. So let's get to the chopper. How can you use the GO 3 to make better videos? First off, settings. In the camera, swipe down and select the settings icon in the next screen to set the bitrate to high and also tweak that sharpness setting. I recommend using low or medium sharpness depending on your taste, but anything above that looks too digitally sharp for me, yeah. After that, it's time for the camera menu by swiping from the right side of the screen. Color, go flat for the most dynamic range. It needs a bit of color grading in the edit, but therefore it looks better and you're flexible. And regarding video modes and resolutions, you get the best quality by shooting in video mode at 2.7K. But if you want the most flexibility during the edit, switch into free frame mode in 1440p. That captures the world sensor and you can reframe and animate your shots later in the Insta360 Studio app. Talking about the Studio app, you can also tweak your footage a bit more there. If you shot in free frame, turn on flow state stabilization, set that FOV to linear and use Color Plus or Clarity Plus just to your liking. It generally looks a bit better with either of them. Before exporting, select H.265 for better compression and choose 100 Mbits to ensure you don't lose quality. You could also export in ProRes, it's a bit easier to edit on slow computers, but the files are huge, so I would say most of you guys don't actually need that. So much about the settings, but now the fun begins. This isn't called the GO 3 for no reason because it literally goes everywhere. The GO 3 itself is magnetic, so you can quickly attach it everywhere where there's metal. You can additionally use the magnet pendant to magnetically mount it to your shirt. And then there is the monkey tail mount, which lets you attach it to lots of things like a snake that wraps around everything. I don't understand why they call it monkey tail mount, to be honest, because it really looks and acts like a snake. You can literally put that in front of you and it looks like a cobra is looking at you. And using this in this cobra position is actually great because it's like a normal tripod. What makes it actually pretty versatile. Then there's also the easy clip, which gives you a few more mounting options, but they are quite special. Motorbike lovers, first ups for you. This isn't just about strapping an action cam on your helmet. Mount this magnetic wizard on your bike's handle, the fuel tank, the sides, or even on the leg guards and capture the road like never before. Of course, don't forget that you can put the GO 3 on the road as well. Better on a quiet one though. And for the everyday person, use your environment to find interesting shots. Attach it to a drawer to capture the slide when opening it, a swinging door or its handle to capture opening it in a more interesting way, or clip it to the antenna of your drone controller to film yourself navigating the drone. Pretty interesting shot. I wanted to show you that with my FPV remote controller because it looks somewhat like that, but I had to send in my FPV drone for repair together with the remote controller for obvious reasons, so I can't show you the exact shot right now. However, never do that while you actually fly your drone, at least if you want to fly a bit farther away, because it might actually reduce the reach of your antennas. But there's more you can do with your clothes. You can, for example, attach it to the bottom of your pant while riding your motorbike or bicycle for a low side angle view, but avoid certain mount spots. We're keeping it family friendly here. You could follow me on OnlyFans for that one. Just kidding, I'm not actually there. Now, we all love those fancy FPV drone fly-through shots, but they are quite hard to get, right? At least without crashing. Luckily, you can get similar shots just on a smaller scale, but therefore through even smaller gaps with the Insta360 GO 3. Just use the monkey tail, which is actually a snake mount, or your usual selfie stick and push or pull the GO 3 through any gap you can imagine. It's certainly not a replacement for actual FPV shots, but it's quite similar and sometimes even better. Another shot type that I really love and talk a lot about is hyperlapses, and luckily the GO 3, similar to 360 cameras, is also great for that. Now, the trick for great hyperlapses isn't just speed, it's purpose. Instead of randomly walking around with your GO 3, give every hyperlapse a point. Move it towards a subject, let it circle around one, or at least transition from place to place. I suggest using freeframe mode to shoot your hyperlapses, as a time shift mode feels a bit limiting to me. So just shoot a normal video using freeframe, load it into the studio app, speed it up to make it a hyperlapse, make sure that motion blur is added by the app with the motion blur icon, and voila, your hyperlapse should come out great. Now, we talked a lot about cool, fancy shots that you can get with the Insta360 GO 3, but I also have to say that it's a great camera to just document a life and its aspects that you would like to make videos about. I used the GO 2 already nearly 2 years ago to document my FPV drone journey, and the GO 3 does that even better thanks to its wireless connection between the camera and the screen, so you don't even have to be close to the camera while capturing yourself. So you can easily frame your shots and capture what you're doing while not even having to be close to your camera. That's why the Insta360 GO 3 clearly shows me that quality alone doesn't define cinematic, vision and story does, and the Insta360 GO 3 is just a tool overall, albeit a pretty good one in many situations. So go out there, experiment, push boundaries, make every shot count, and show the world your vision. I see you next time.